this video, we're going to talk about the metric topology. To understand this topology, it is necessary that you know already what a metric or what a metric space is. The idea is that we have a metric space, XD, and we can generate a topology with this metric just by taking as a basis the collection of all the balls for every X in the space and every radius greater than zero. This will give us a basis for the topology, and from that basis we can get the topology itself. So on the basis, V is going to be just a set of balls defined with this metric. If you don't remember, the balls VD with center in X and radius epsilon is just a set of all the elements in the space for which the distance between X and Y is smaller than epsilon. So the idea is, if this is our space, then every time I graph X in X, I will consider all the balls centered in this element with all possible radiuses. And I will do this for each element in my space. So you can imagine how big this space is. This is just the basis. Now for the topology, we would have to take any finite intersection and arbitrary unions of elements in these spaces. Metric topologies are huge. So now let's see a few properties. We can, for example, take the real numbers with the usual metric. So let's think what the balls look like in this space. We have given some x in the real numbers. We will consider the ball with center in x and some radius epsilon. We know that these sets are x minus epsilon, x plus epsilon. This is just an open interval. And so it's very simple to see that the topology induced by the usual metric in the real line is the same as the standard topology of the line. Well, let's see another example. If we consider any set X, we can always define a metric D called the discrete metric that is defined as, given some X and Y in the space, the distance between them will be 1, 0. It's 1 if X is different from Y, and 0 if they're the same. So this metric, if we are at X in our space, and we consider now the balls, for example, of radius 1, this ball is actually the singleton X. And so obviously this ball is part of the basis B. And so what this means is that the topology induced by the discrete metric is the same as the discrete topology. Remember that the discrete topology was part of X, and the basis for this topology was the set of all the singletons X. So that is why these two topologies are the same. Now let's see a particular metric that will be very useful for us later on. This metric is called the bounded metric. And to define it, let's suppose we have a metric space, XD. We will define a new metric, D bar, given two elements of our set, X and Y. This is going to be defined as the minimum between the distance with our original metric in the space between these two elements and 1. So what happens is, if we think about the real line, so let's think about this metric, the balls for this metric are going to be given some element X, very small balls, because at first we're going to have that this number is the minimum, and as soon as I hit distance 1, so I will have here the ball of radius 1, in which case these two are the same, and then as soon as this one is greater than 1, this one will win, and then we just get all the space. So we have balls for small radiuses and then just the whole space. So this is showing us, given that we have the small balls in here, The topology induced by this metric is going to contain all the poles for radius smaller than 1. And then we just have all space. And what this proves is that the topology induced by the usual metric we had in our space is the same as the topology induced by the bounded metric. So just given any metric space, if we define the bounded metric, the topologies induced by these two metrics is the same. And the reason behind this is very simple. Let's see an important result. So let's say we have a set X and two metrics, D and D prime. Two metrics defined in our space X. So we have the two topologies. D induces a topology tau and D prime induces a topology tau prime. So now, if you remember the lemma that we saw in our basis video that is on the screen right now, it's very simple to realize that T is going to be a subset of T prime, so T prime is finer than T, if and only if. For every X in the space and every radius positive, there exists another radius such that the pole with the metric T prime, so the one that induces the finer topology with center in X and radius this delta that we want to find, is a subset of the ball constructed with the metric T with center in X and radius epsilon. This is very simple once we know this lemma, because we know exactly what our bases are. The bases of tau prime are the balls constructed with the metric T prime, and the bases for tau are the balls constructed with the metric T. So for every basis element in tau, that is for every X and epsilon, for this basis element BD, we want to find a basis element in tau prime, so we want to find a radius and this basis element that is contained here. And obviously this is something that we can do with these two metrics, D and D bar. So that is why these two topological spaces are the same, because we can do this inclusion on both directions. So with this we finish the video. Remember that if you want to support the channel, there are many ways for you to do so. You can make donations on Ko-fi. You can also support us on Patreon to get exclusive content and amazing merchandise. Or you can buy a t-shirt in a mathematics t-shirt store. See you in the next one.